Hi, it's Zainab Zaitoun. Today I'm gonna explain vectors for grade 9. This is the second part out of 3, so if you didn't see the first part, check my previous video. The objectives of this part is to recall translation, construct the images of a point, line, and circle by translation of a given vector, figure out the properties of translation, and of course at the end we'll do some applications on these objectives. First, let's recall translation. In this figure, you have a triangle ABC and another triangle A prime, B prime, C prime. This triangle is obtained by sliding the triangle ABC in the direction of the line AA prime, in distance from A to A prime, and of a length equal to the length of the segment AA prime. But what does that mean? This means that if you take any point on the triangle ABC, let's say C for example, you can notice that the point C is translated into the point C prime in the direction of the line AA prime, because you can see that CC prime is parallel to AA prime, and in the sense from A to A prime, and of a length equal to the segment AA prime. You can notice that CC prime is equal to AA prime. What do we call, or what can we say about this triangle A prime, B prime, C prime? It's the image of ABC by the translation of vector AA prime. Now, if you take any other point other than C, this also applies. Now, what's the image of a point by translation? Suppose that you have a point A and the vector BC. Now, the question is, what's the image, or translate, these have the same meaning, D of A by the translation of vector BC. So, you need to find B, which is the image or translate of A by the translation of vector BC. Try to link it with the previous slide. If you want, pause the video and try to figure it out by yourself. So this is the point and the vector. In order to translate A by the vector, by the translation of a vector BC, you need to draw a vector from A which is equal to BC. What does it mean to have a vector from A equal to BC? Recall that they should have the same sense, direction, and magnitude. So let's draw this vector. Starting from A, it should be parallel to BC to have the same direction, and it should have the same sense and same length. So this is D, which is the image of A by the translation of vector BC, or you can call it the translate of A by the vector BC. So from here we can draw out the conclusion that if D is the translate of A by the vector BC, then AD vector is equal to BC vector, and then AD CB is a parallelogram. So this is a summary of what I said. Now, how to find the image of a line by translation? So consider the line CD and the vector AB. What's the image of CD by the translation of vector AB? So also try to do it by yourself, pause the video. Before you pause the video, I can give you a hint. Recall that any line is defined by two points. So in order to find the image of the line CD by the translation of vector AB, you need to choose any two points on the line, not necessarily C and D, and then find the images of these two points as we did before, and then join the images to get the line. So this is the figure. I'll choose first the point C on the line. I'll translate it by the translation of a vector AB. So how do I translate C by this vector? I should draw a vector from C, which is equal to AB, as we did before. So I start from C, I draw a vector which is equal to AB, so they should have the same direction, and same sense, and same length. So these are equal vectors. Now you choose any other point on the line, not necessarily D, but I'll choose D because it's already there. So I'll translate it by the vector AB, so you should draw a vector starting from D, which is equal to AB. So this is the vector. So F is the image of D and E is the image of C by the translation of the vector AB. Now how do I get the image of this line? You just join these two points. So I'll join these two points to get the image of the line. So this is the image of this line by the translation of vector AB. Now this is a remark based on what we did. Notice that the image or the translation of a line D by a translation of a vector is a line D prime parallel to D. Let's look back at our image, at our diagram. So here you can notice that these two lines are parallel. You can do the proof by yourself. I'll do it quickly. Since E is the translation of is the translate of C by the translation of the vector AB, then we can say that AB is equal to CE vector. Same for DF vector, we can say that DF vector is equal to AB vector. Hence, CE vector is equal to DF vector. So the quadrilateral CDFE is a parallelogram. Hence, the two lines CD and EF are parallel. Now, this is a recap for what I just did, if you want to copy it down. So this is how to translate a line by a vector AB. Now, how to find the image of a segment by translation. So this is should be pretty easy for you. Consider the segment CD and the vector AB. What's the image of CD by the translation of vector AB? Now, there is a slight difference between this and the translation of a line. The only difference is that in the case of the segment, you're forced to translate the extremities of the segment and not any points, like in the case of the line. So here you need to translate C by the vector AB, and you need to translate D by the vector AB, and then join the images. So now to translate C by the vector AB, I need to draw a vector from C, which is equal to AB. So this is a vector. I'll call the image E. You can call it whatever you want. So now we have CE vector is equal to AB vector. Now we do the same for D. In order to translate D by the translation of vector AB, we draw a vector from D, which is equal to AB. So this is parallel to AB and have the same sense as AB and same length. So now in order to get the image of this segment, we just join these two images, E and F. So I'll join this image, the images, E and F. So this is the image of CD. Also, this is a recap for what we did now. So translate the extremities of the segment and join them to get the image. Now we still have to find the image of a circle by translation. Let C be a circle of center O and radius R. What's the image of C by the translation of vector AB? In order to find the image of a circle C, you need to translate the origin by the vector AB, and then draw the new circle with the same radius as the original circle. So here we go. Let's translate A by the translation of vector AB. So again, I need to draw a vector from O, which is equal to the vector AB. Let's call this O prime, but of course you can call it whatever you want. So this is the new origin. Now you need to draw a circle of center O prime and with the same radius as the original circle. So the radius of the original circle is 2 cm. So this circle, the new circle, should have a radius of 2 cm also. So this is the translation or the image of the circle C by the translation of vector AB. This is also a recap of what we did. So find the image O prime of O by translation of vector AB, then draw the new circle of center O prime and the same radius R. Now, from what we did, we can draw out the properties of translation by yourself. You can know that translation conserves collinearity of points, parallelism, and orthogonality. This means, for example, perpendicular lines, the length, the angles, area of a surface, congruency of figures. If you're not convinced by these properties, try them out by yourself. So, for example, for the first property, collinearity of points, draw 3 collinear points and any vector you want. Translate these 3 points by the same vector. You'll notice that the images of the 3 points are also collinear. Same for here, for example, congruency of figures. Draw any figure you want, for example, rhombus. Translate this rhombus by the same vector. You'll figure out that the image of this rhombus is exactly the same as the original one. Do some applications. Given a right triangle ABC at B, find the image of A, denoted by D, so they called it D, by the translation of vector BC. So we have this triangle and we need to translate A by the translation of vector BC. So as we did before, we draw a vector from A, which is equal to BC. So we go in this sense and this direction and of length 4 cm as BC. So this is D. Now, what's the nature of ABCD? So recall that when you have, if D is the image of A by the translation of vector BC, then you can say that AD vector is equal to BC vector. And this implies that ABCD is a parallelogram. But the angle B is 90 degrees. Here ABC equal to 90 because ABC is right triangle at B. So ABCD is a rectangle. I'll show you the answers at the end to copy them. C, find the translate of B by the translation of vector BC. So this is the triangle. I need to find the translate of B by the translation of vector BC. Some of you might directly know that the image would be C. If you don't know, then do the same steps as we did in A. We draw a vector from B, which is equal to BC. So if you draw a vector from B equal to BC, the image would be C. Now, locate E such that AE is equal to CB. They want you to locate E such that AE would be equal to CB. So this is the vector CB, and you have that AE is equal to CB. So since the vector is AE, then the origin is A, I should go. In what sense? Since CB goes from this, from right to left, so I should go from right to left. So this is the point E, which is the translate of A by the vector CB. Now the last part, find the image of the line AC, this line, not segment, line AC, by the translation of vector AB. So you need to translate this line. Recall that you need to choose any two points on this line and translate them by the vector AB. So to translate the vector AC by vector AB, I'll choose A and C. You can choose any other points, as I said. So in order to translate A by the vector AB, then A would be, the image of A would be B, obviously. Now to translate C by the vector AB, you need to draw a vector starting from C and equal to the vector AB. So this is the image of C. Now this, now B is the image of A and F is the image of C. Now, in order to get the image of the line, you join these two images, these two points, B and F. So this is the line, which is the image of the line AC by the translation of vector AB. So this is the final diagram of this question. And these are the answers for parts B and C. You can copy them. Now, this is the second exercise. Copy it and try to do it alone. And these are the answers of this exercise. You can check them when you finish solving. I'll solve exercise 3 with you. So given C, a circle of center C and diameter AB, D is is a point on C equidistant from A and B. Now, first part, locate E such that DE is equal to DA plus DB. So now we have sum of two vectors. So based on the previous video, you should either use Chase's relation or parallelogram rule in order to construct E. Since they have the same origin, then you use parallelogram rule. Now, in order to locate E, E is the fourth vertex of the parallelogram DAEB. So, in order to locate E, you need to complete the parallelogram ADBE as we did in the previous video. So, let's complete the parallelogram. Let's join AD and B. Now, in order to complete the parallelogram, you draw a line from A, which is parallel and equal to DB. So this is the line or the segment. Now this is the parallelogram and E is the fourth vertex of the parallelogram. Part 2, prove that AEBD is a square. Let's look back at the figure. So ADBE is a square. Now since DA plus DB is equal to DE, when you see this relation, you can directly say that ADBE is a parallelogram. Now, it's given that D is equidistant from A and B, so you have DA is equal to DB. So the quadrilateral ADBE is a rhombus. But also the angle ADB is equal to 90 degrees since D is facing the diameter AB. So this becomes a square. ADBE is a square. And this is the solution if you want to copy it. So that's all for this video. We still have one part on coordinate system, so on vectors in coordinate system. If you have any questions, don't hesitate to drop it down in the comment section. Hope you enjoyed the video. Bye.